Hello friends, today we are going to study cyclic process. In that, first, what is process, what is cyclic process, and how can we calculate work done in cyclic process. In our channel, we already studied about, in first video of thermodynamics, basic concepts. In second video, polytropic process. And isothermal, isobaric, isochoric and adiabatic processes. So we already know what is a process. Process is change in a state of system. Now what is a cyclic process then? See, cyclic process, when a system undergoes series of processes such that the final state of last process is the initial state of the first process. Final state of the last process is the initial state of the first process. The set of processes is termed as a cyclic process. See, we have given one graph, PV graph, and for example of a cyclic process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5 and 5 to 1. At point 1 we start, at point 1 we end. Such process is called as a cyclic process. Other examples which are very important for MCQs in MPSC. First, heat engine, refrigerator and air conditioner, Carnot cycle. These are most important examples of cyclic processes. Now see about the graph. We can draw any graph of this, such as PV graph, PT graph, TV graph for showing cyclic processes. But one condition must, which is loop must be closed, because when and when only loop is closed, the final state of a last process is the initial state of a first process. Also this shape of a closed loop may be triangular, circular, rectangular. In between stages means this stage, in between stages may have different volume, pressure, temperature, but here we observe only final and initial state, which must be same. See, as the initial and final state of a cyclic process is same, then the initial and final properties of a substance will also be same. Thus, for a cyclic process, change in any property is equal to zero. From this, what can we say? In cyclic process, change in internal energy is zero. How? See, delta U means internal energy. What is the formula? We already know. NCV delta T. But delta T is here 0 because in cyclic process T2 is equal to T1, P2 is equal to P1 and V2 is equal to V1. Hence delta T means change in a temperature is a 0. We put 0, then delta U is equal to 0. Hence according to first law of thermodynamics, Q is equal to W plus delta U. Q means heat supply. Delta U already 0. Q is equal to W means heat supplied is equal to work done. Now see, how can we calculate work done in cyclic process? For calculation of a work done in cyclic process, we have to draw PV graph only. For showing cyclic process, we can draw PV, PT, TV graph, but for calculation of a work done, we have to draw only PV graph. And area of a PV graph is equal to work done, means area of that closed loop. If a graph is clockwise, then work done is positive. If a graph is anti-clockwise, then work done negative. See, if there is a PV graph and rectangular closed loop here, the area of this rectangular graph get work done, but this is clockwise, hence work done is positive, whereas work done is negative because it is anti-clockwise. See some examples. PV graph here, P to P, V to V, means area of this rectangle P 2P minus P, and here 2V minus V, P into V, work done P V. Why positive here? Because clockwise direction. Now, if the work done in these two triangles are same, if triangles having same area and same direction also, clockwise, here also clockwise, area is the same, then work done is the same. If we have to calculate total work done here, see, this direction is given, these areas are same, if we have given, then see, this triangle showing clockwise direction, this triangle showing anti-clockwise direction, area is the same, then work done will be this positive minus this negative, work done zero. Again, see this anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. Okay, here work done will be positive, why? Area of a bigger circle minus area of a smaller circle is equal to work done, and this bigger circle sign is positive.